Hello and welcome. Today we are talking about top 5 differences between hookahs. Roll the intro. Okay, so the first difference between hookahs is their height. The height doesn't affect the hookah whatsoever. It doesn't affect how we smoke it or how the hookah itself works. But what it affects is how it looks. So as you can see, we have a tall hookah right here. It's gonna be taller on the table, so you're gonna have it more high up. Small hookah here doesn't affect, again, whatsoever. It's just smaller, more compact. The only difference is, for example, with this Pinoccio, we have a smaller base of the hookah, so the water is gonna get more warm more quickly. So the smoke is gonna get warmer as well. So keep that one in mind. So the second main difference is the material. As you can see here, this one is made out of stainless steel. You can see hookahs made out of aluminium, glass, and so on and so forth. Generally, I would go for the stainless steel because it's durable, it doesn't catch odors that easily. I would stay away from aluminium completely because it just ain't good. So you can have hookahs made entirely out of glass, which I wouldn't recommend either, because glass doesn't conduct heat very well and you're not gonna have as pleasant time smoking it as you would with a stainless one. Secondly, we have to talk about the materials on the outside. So here we have wood, which is beautiful. It's gonna have a nice rustic feature usually, but you're gonna need to oil the wood. Otherwise it's gonna get worn and it's gonna start look a bit ashy. Secondly, we have plastic, like here. You can't go wrong with plastic, but it's glass, as I talked about earlier, I don't like it, but some people might, so it exists. And secondly, this is, for example, made entirely out of stainless steel. It's durable, however, it's quite heavy to pick up. I wouldn't recommend traveling with a hookah like this or transporting it longer distances because it's just heavy. Hookahs have generally 3 types of connectors. First one being ground joint, which looks like this. Put it there and it's held together by friction and friction only, so it's hard to pull out. Personally, my favorite. Second one would be seal made by O-rings on the connector itself, and you just put it there. It's a bit harder to put in, but it seals the hookah very nicely and usually doesn't have any kinds of problems. And lastly, my least favorite is the one with seal like this, connected like this. Just put the seal on the connector, or the other way around, put the seal inside the hookah like this and press in the connector. I usually wouldn't recommend this connector personally, just because I don't like it. Otherwise it doesn't have any flaws of its own, but yeah, for me personally it would be this one. Yes, the round joint. Okay, so the fourth main difference being hookahs without diffuser and hookahs with diffuser. Hookahs without diffuser are gonna make a lot more noise and it's gonna be harder to smoke. Like, it's gonna be harder to pull the smoke from the hookah itself. Whereas hookahs with diffuser are gonna make less noise and the pull from the hookah is gonna be much easier. Also, you're gonna have some of those diffusers that you can take off the hookah itself. So this one is modifiable by a diffuser. So you can either take it off when you want the smoke to be harder to pull from the hookah and you want to be louder with the hookah, or you can just put it easily back on when you are going to watch a movie, for example, or you just don't want to make a lot of noise. So that's the fourth difference. So the fifth and the last difference is the style of the patch. As you can see, all those look pretty much the same when you look at them for the first time. But for example, when I blow into the union hookah here, you can see the smoke comes straight like this from the heart of the hookah. Now I'm gonna demonstrate the Panda hookah. And as you can see, I'm just gonna switch these out real quick. As you can see, this perch slightly pops up and the smoke comes in like a star, basically, shape. If you look once again. This time I blow a little bit harder, and when you do that, it pops out even more and this smoke comes almost in the same direction as on the Union Hookah. We're gonna look at the Voodoo now, and with this hookah, it's a bit different than the last two. As you'll see in a second. Because the smoke travels up through this and around the stem and comes basically down right around the hookah, like this. You can even see special, I would say, types of perches, those which are switchable. For example, like in this ocean right here. And when I take this, you can see the smoke comes through these little holes in between the blades. But the special thing is, when you turn this around a bit, like so, there's a switch in there which will allow the smoke to flow through these holes. So that's just a little advice to keep in mind when you go around shopping for hookahs. And I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please leave a message down in the comments, press a like, subscribe to our channel, and I'll see you again very, very soon. And as always, happy smoking!